Hello everyone, my name is Leonardo Leiva Lamas. I am the early stage researcher aide in the TINU5G project. TINU5G is a European training network in the frame of the Marie-Soz Pecourin Innovative Training Network of the European Commission Horizon 2020 frame. With this presentation, I seek to introduce the motive principle and most important aspect of joint radar and communication systems. The table of content is divided into four sections. The first one is devoted to introduce the concept of joint radar and communication systems, as well as the motive that led to research in this novel area. The second section gives an idea of how has been the development of the coexistence between radar and communication over time. Section three focuses on the waveform that have been employed for the design of RADCOM systems. Section four briefly introduces what could be the enabling technology seeking to increase both systems' performance. Radar and wireless communication are the most commonly used radio features by both civil and military applications. However, while radar and wireless communication technology are well-established fields and rely on common principles in the last decades, they have evolved separately. The independent design of these systems wastes valuable radio resources and requires strong regulatory constraints to mitigate inter-system interference. So, the radio spectrum scarcity combined with the emergence of novel applications requiring both functionalities has driven research in joint radar and communication systems. For instance, intelligent transportation systems require smart cars to be capable of individually sensing their driving conditions and cooperatively sharing this information to other vehicles. The protection against inter-system interference in radio has been usually granted from the fulfillment of regulatory measures defined by national and international bodies. This is known as traditional coexistence. In the traditional coexistence approach, engineers only take care about transmitter and receiver proper performance. However, the need for more and more spectrum has also led to research on new interference management techniques and concepts allowing more efficient use of radio resources. So, new strategies like cognitive coexistence and joint radar and communication systems has been the object of significant research in recent years. In the cognitive coexistence approach, radar and communication are still different systems with different purposes, but unlike the traditional coexistence, they may share the same frequency band. Spectrum sharing is enabled by cognitive radio techniques where one service can use the band allocated to the other as long as it does not cause harmful interference. This more efficient approach has been recently implemented and has partially responded to the spectral congestion problem. On the other hand, the co-design approach breaks from how spectral resources has been traditionally accessed. Contrary to previous methods, communication and radar systems are no longer treated as independent entities or as interference sources. Here, radar and communication systems are designed together from the ground up, resulting in a RADCOM system where common elements in both technology, such as antenna system and RF from a circuit, are shared. Waveforms employed in RADCOM systems can be classified depending on the principal role it was intended for in two major parties, radar-based joint waveform, I talk about now, and communication-based joint waveform. So the radar-based joint waveform approach is mainly based on the idea of embedding information into radar emissions, having as a constraint to minimize the adverse effect that this could originate on the original system performance. Several information embedding approach has been proposed so far. For instance, the waveform diversity-based information embedding. Here, n bits of information per pulse are embedded by selecting the radar waveform on a pulse-to-pulse basis from a set of k equal to 2 raised to the n waveforms. The corresponding transmit signal vector can be expressed by this first expression here, this one here. Another technique that embeds deformation in radar emission is the phase modulation-based information embedding approach, where deformation is embedded by controlling the phase of the signal. The total transmit signal is given by this expression here, by this sequence expression. And there are other alternatives, of course, to embed information in radar waveforms, where some of them employ multi-carrier waveform and multiple antenna systems, adding a further degree of freedom in space or frequency domains. But although the employment of well-known radar waveform for the design of radcon systems achieve a favorable performance for sensing functions, for communication function has the disadvantage that the symbol rate corresponds to the pulse repetition frequency, which is generally significantly lower than the throughput achieved by a dedicated communication systems in the same bandwidth. So the communication-based joint waveform approach aims to realize functional radcon transceiver through the use of communication waveforms. Here, waveforms based on code and multi-carrier are the most widely used for the design of a joint radar and communication systems. First, I will talk about the code-based approach and then the multi-carrier-based approach. Several features make code-based waveform a strong candidate to be used in systems with both functionalities. For instance, a similar waveform principle to those employed in communication systems can be found performing sensing functions. Furthermore, they are recognized for having good correlation properties, which is a valuable feature for a precise radar performance. Besides, it is possible to code with a multi-user scenario by means of a set of orthogonal spreading code. But there are some drawbacks. For instance, the user data rate is kept constant while increasing the length of the spreading factor. This increases the bandwidth, which leads to inefficient use of the frequency spectrum for the communication systems. Other issues arise while estimating the Doppler frequency shift. This is because the correlation computation between the received signal and the frequency shifted copies of the original transmitted signal, such an algorithm will consume enormous computational resources, being hardly feasible to implement in practice. Besides, the imperfect nature of the spread code sequence and the Doppler shift have an adverse impact over the peak-to-side-to-loss ratio of the time domain correlation function. Furthermore, there are other trade-offs that arise regarding the correlation property of the spread code sequence. So when designing the spread cellular Raman sequences, as the desired property for sensing and communication are in odd one to the other, while the pseudo-random sequences should have ideal autocorrelation properties for sensing purpose, also it should have ideal cross-correlation properties for communication purposes. Since a few orthogonal sequences must be available to cope with a multi-user scenario. Another waveform that has been investigated for radcon systems is OFDM. This is due to several facts. For instance, OFDM has become the leading multi-carrier-based waveform candidate for a large number of communication technology, such as Wi-Fi, LTE, and 5G. But it has also been verified that OFDM waveforms are adequate for radar applications. Moreover, since an increase in the system bandwidth has a favorable impact on parameters of both systems, such as the data rate for the communication application and the range resolution for sensing application, the use of this waveform enables to dynamically adjust the available bandwidth as it required by both applications. Nevertheless, using OFDM waveform and reconsistency has some drawbacks as well, while concerning almost always the radar performance. For instance, due to the cyclic prefix necessary to fight the Fedus multipath, autocorrelation property is far from adequate. As shown in this figure here, when compared with traditional radar waveforms, the peak-to-side loss ratio of the autocorrelation function is quite less, which can be catastrophic for ranging of targets. Further, the data dependence and employing multiple subcarriers result in a highly variant time signal envelope, affecting the peak to average power ratio, which can provoke significant issues for radar power circuitry. Achieving a functional convergence does not only depend on the use of suitable waveforms, meaning that technology trends and the state of the art on both fronts should be incorporated into the design process of future RADCOM systems. One key technology to enable functional joint radar and communication systems comprises enable transceiver employing a large number of antennas, a technique known as massive MIMO. Wireless communication systems take advantages of massive MIMO by exploiting the phase fading property of the channel, allowing to gain spatial or spatial diversity or spatial multiplexing. Another technological trend regarding the design of RADCOM systems is the use of millimetric wave bands. This band has abundant radio resources available that allow radar application and vision range to benefit from wide bandwidth, providing high range resolution vital for accurate identification of people, buildings, and other objects. Besides future wireless broadband communication systems, motivated by the constant demand for higher data rates and consequently in urgent need of more radio resources, will migrate to upper frequency bands. By combining massive MIMO and millimetric wave, a large number of antennas can be arranged in a small form factor, incorporating portability and allowing the exploitation of spatial processing techniques such as beamforming. However, the hardware limitation inherent in high frequency carriers lead to several challenges regarding algorithms complexity and implementation cost. Hybrid analog digital beamforming, where the signal processing is divided into the analog and digital domain, is being studied extensively in recent time to counterbalance complexities and cost. Thanks all for your attention.